Another day, another dollar. Welcome to the new video, guys. Finished training morning clients so far. Waiting on a new client, a potential new client that I'm gonna meet with, chat with them about what they wanna do, what their goals are, how many times a week, all that type of stuff. Also waiting on a potential new trainer to come in here. Meet with him, kinda see how many clients he has, how often he's gonna be in here. All right, so after I meet with the new client and the new trainer, I'm gonna work out, thanks to Anzi. I got a new Olympic lifting program to follow, so I'm gonna follow that for, I think it's for 4 weeks. I'm gonna try that out, hopefully improve my form and technique and also get stronger in the snatch and clean and jerk. And then I'm also gonna go get some cool stuff done. I'll show you later. Oh yeah, so remember that space that was on Max's side of the gym? Look at what we did. So we ripped up all this crappy old green carpet, scraped off all the glue underneath, then we laid some nice tiles down. So again, this is where the new dedicated yoga space will be in District. We're gonna get some dividers, kind of like curtains or something to kind of divide everything, just to separate it from the actual office. So it's coming along real nice. And then there's a sign. No shoes on the floor, por favor. So it's time to lift. So looking at the program that Anzi hooked it up with, what do I have to do today? What do we got? Clean and jerk, clean pull, front squat. And thank you to him and Fatima for helping me with my technique and form so that Team China will be giving me a call in a few months. Time to dust off these bad boys. My lifting shoes, have not been using these lately just because of my hip. Wasn't able to squat heavy and stuff, but everything is a lot better, so let's go. And you know, when the gym is empty, I listen to country, so. Now that the workout's over, we're gonna get into what the video's really about. And it's gonna be about recovery. So I listed, not in any particular order, what I think is really important for recovery. So I guess the top few are things that you could do on your own, and then the bottom few are things that you gotta like pay for a service or have someone else do it for you. But just real quick, sleep, hydrate, nutrition, rest, mobility and stretching, self-myofascial release, so like foam rolling, that type of thing, active recovery, chiropractics, massage, and cryo or ice. So throughout the day, I'm gonna go a little more in detail about each of these. Obviously, I'm not gonna go into super detail about it, but I'm gonna go do most of these things. I at least show you most of the things I can do today. One of the things I'm not gonna do today is massage, just because I got a massage not too long ago. And I'm also poor, so I don't wanna pay for it right now. So you're not gonna see me get a massage, but I think you'll see a little bit of everything else. Other than sleep, you won't see me sleep. That's just weird. When it comes to hydration, obviously drinking a lot of water is important. This is water with Crystal Light in it. So I put Crystal Light just because it tastes better, makes my water taste better, makes it more fun. So I try to drink about 3 of these a day. This is the first one. I like to carry these around instead. These are 1.5 liters instead of carrying around one of these giant gallon jugs, which is 3.79. So if I drink 3 of these, it's actually more than this. Cool. So, one down. All right, so I'm not gonna get into super detail about, you know, why water is important. I'm sure all of you know why it's important. Most of your muscle is water, you know, so you definitely wanna drink a lot of water. You wanna replenish that. So if it's hot, if you're sweating a lot, you definitely wanna replenish the water that you lost. Water is good for lubrication. Water is good for transport of nutrients into your body and into your muscles, and also waste products out. So drink a lot of water. How much you should drink, I don't know. You're going to hear different numbers from everyone. I used to hear 8 ounces or half your body weight in fluid ounces is like the minimum. Typically, you want to do double that, I think, if you're an athlete and you're going to be sweating a lot and you're working out a lot. I simply try to get about 1 gallon a day, and I think that's good enough. Yeah. Another very important part of recovery is your nutrition. So this is what I'm eating after my workout. I'll show you as I get to my desk. So nutrition is very important. Before I worked out, I usually like to get some type of simple carb. So I get like rice cakes before I work out. If I'm at home, I'll usually eat like cereal or oatmeal or something before I work out. But definitely wanna get some carbs just to fuel your workout. And then after your workout, everyone knows or has heard about taking a protein shake, that 30-minute window for your gains and stuff. I don't think it's that big of a deal when you get it, but you definitely want to get something to eat after you work out. And I don't think it has to be a protein shake, but I like to eat meals. So Easy Meals hooks me up with meals. So I got some asparagus and shrimp, protein 50, carb 34, fat 2. So really lean post-workout meal. I think it's important to replenish the carbs, the glycogen loss that you had as you worked out, and also the protein for recovery purposes. So, yeah. So another important thing to do to help with your recovery is mobility work and stretching. I'm not gonna go through stretching just because I'm sure most of you guys know how to stretch. There's plenty of stretches to do depending on whatever body part is tight. Typically the stretching is done at the end of your workout. Mobility, I tend to do before my workout, especially ones that help me with the movement that I'm doing for that day. And then I'll also do mobility and stretching on my rest days. So if I'm not gonna lift anything, I definitely try to get some mobility work just to kind of, you know, get the joints moving, help break up any scar tissue, kind of get some more movement into those sore muscles. So I will show you some of my staple mobility drills. Again, these are just some of the ones that I do pretty frequently. They're definitely not, you know, the only ones to do, but they're the ones that I like to do, and I tend to do them daily. So I will show you guys. So another good recovery practice to do daily is SMR, self-myofascial release. So, you know, most commonly people think of foam rolling. So these are common tools. You got a foam roller, lacrosse ball, got a rolling stick. All of these are good things to do. I actually like doing them after you work out. A lot of people like doing it before, but I think doing after is better just because, you know, after working out, your muscles get tight. You definitely want to get some motion through there. You want to get, you know, blood flowing through there. You want to kind of just loosen up those tight muscle fibers. So again, like it says, self-myofascial release. So these are basically just like a self-massage, all right? So I used to use these, but now I got this bad boy, the Hyper. So like I said, I have not been using the foam roller or the lacrosse ball or any of that stuff much lately, just because I got this bad boy, Hyper Vault by Hyper Ice. It's just a massage gun, a vibration massager. Feels really good, so it has all the same benefits, but it feels better. So, you know, helps with recovery, helps, you know, break up any scar tissue, helps with soreness, stiffness, helps increase range of motion in your joints just by loosening everything up around the joints, and promotes blood flow with the vibrations. So as you can see, there's three different levels. I usually put on the middle one and then go to town on my hip. My hip is broken. Like I said earlier, I'm not gonna get a massage today because I got one not too long ago and I don't wanna spend the money on another one. So I'm not gonna do that, but I can at least show you this, a massage table. Yeah, so, yep. All right, so next stop, next recovery place, at my friend, good friend, Dr. Gregory Lee's office in Fairfax, Virginia. It's called Active Family Wellness. I'll link it in descriptions. So I'm gonna get some chiropractic adjustments done today. So let's go inside, get treated, and talk to him for a little bit. All right, so I'm in Dr. Gregory Lee's office, Active Family Wellness in Fairfax, Virginia. So I'm gonna get treated. So, you know, I do a lot of powerlifting. I've recently been doing a lot of Olympic lifting. So I put a lot of wear and tear on my body, lifting all that heavy weight. So I need to get adjusted just so I feel good. So let's talk to Dr. Gregory Lee real quick, just to see what would you say like an adjustment is for? What is the main adjustment?
All right, so the adjustment, we're focusing in and finding a subluxation, which is a misalignment of the spine. When you have a subluxation, that affects, irritates, and inflames the nerves. You see like these nerves coming out?
Mm-hmm.
When you inflame these, where do these nerves go to? Well, they go to our organ, and specifically our sympathetic, parasympathetic response. What does that mean? When you're sympathetic, that's your go, 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 lift, right? Parasympathetic is your rest and digest. We want to be right in the middle. For too much in the sympathetic, we're gonna get burned out, stressed out, and we're gonna get injured if we're chronically in sympathetic. So the adjustment's gonna help you rest better, recover, sleep better, and help that sympathetic parasympathetic response.
Awesome. All
that ruined it.
And then when I do a lot of chest, if I do like banded face pulls, pull aparts, just, you know, just pull more than I push. I'm not going back. I'll never be the same. Thank God my yesterday's gone. My sins are forgiven. I'm there once I will go. just that sacrum a little differently.
Yeah.
That's gonna help, yeah.
Cool. All right, so another very important part of recovery is sleep. I'm not that great at getting a lot of sleep, but I'm sure you all have heard 8 hours of sleep is optimal for most people. For athletes, you may even need more, but anywhere between 6 hours and 10 hours a night should be good enough sleep for most people. It kind of depends on your daily life and also genetics. And so there's a lot of stuff that plays a role. So you kind of have to test around and see what works best for you. But yeah, again, between 6 and 10 hours is typically enough sleep. The benefits of sleep, obviously, you are more alert, you're more focused when you are well rested. So for an athlete, you're more focused on your lifts, your sport, whatever. You're more alert, you're more quick to react. Reaction time is better when you have more rest. So definitely get your sleep. Another very important factor with sleep is that I'm sure you guys have heard that when you sleep is when you grow. You don't grow in the gym, you grow when you sleep. So when you sleep, that's when most of your growth hormones, HGH, human growth hormone, is produced. And that is what really helps in muscle recovery and muscle building. So you definitely want to get enough sleep so that you can make those gains.
Sorry for the wind. Walking over to my cryo session. First time ever. Thank you, Johnny and Valerie, for giving this to me for my Christmas present. So I don't know much about cryo. I'm gonna, hopefully the guy will let me record in there, and then I'll ask him to kind of describe what cryotherapy is, what the benefits are, and how it aids in recovery. So let's go.
All right, so we're here at Alpha Cryo in Vienna, Virginia. This is my new friend, Sid. He's the owner of this place. So I'm gonna get some cryotherapy done. This is my first time ever doing it. So got my socks and these booties on, just underwear. So got some gloves on too. So how cold does this get?
Bigger gloves.
Oh, bigger gloves, all right, even better.
So you're gonna start off at negative 40.
Negative 40.
That's what the cabin is.
Okay.
And then we're gonna shoot you up to like negative 130. Woo! So that's what the cabin feels like. So there's okay. Two different temperatures. You have the nitrogen that's coming in at like negative 300 plus, but it can't hit your skin at anything over negative 200. It'll
okay.
Literally freeze your skin.
Yeah.
So here, what we do is we plot the cabin temperature, so you'll see, you'll feel what a negative 130 feels like.
Oh, man.
The goal is to try to get you from negative 40 to negative 130 within about two and a half minutes.
2.5 minutes?
Yeah. Here in about 10 to 15 seconds, your brain is gonna send a signal to your body. All the blood from your extremities is actually gonna rush to your core to protect your vital organs.
Okay.
While the blood's in your core, that blood is gonna get cleaned, oxygenated, and enriched with nutrients. Your brain will then identify every area that's weak to stabilize itself. Which is why you will shake, shiver, and burn about 600 to 800 calories. Do a full 360 for me if you don't mind. So what happens when you step out of the chamber, there'll be a dilation effect. Your capillaries expand, and all that super clean blood starts attacking the areas your brain identified weak,
okay.
Naturally getting your body to recover, revitalize, rejuvenate itself. Basically, all we're doing, this is your ice bath on steroids times 10,000.
Yeah.
So you started off at negative 40. I'll zoom down. Right now, you're at negative 94 and dropping, and you got about 80 seconds to go. How are you feeling? Do another turn for me.
It's cold.
Awesome, awesome. The goal is to get you to about negative 130, which is where we're gonna head to here. How are you feeling? You got about a minute to go.
Woo!
So most new people, we start off at about 2 minutes. This is where the breaking point is.
Okay.
Most people can take two minutes, 2.5 minutes, but the goal is to try to really shock your body and get you to go up to like 2.5. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling all right.
Awesome, you're about 130. Right now, you got 45 seconds to go. Do another turn for me. Awesome. So when you get to about 130, it starts to pulsate like this. And it's just gonna keep the cabin around 130, 140.
Okay.
And make sure it doesn't go any lower. If it does go lower, it's gonna drop. It's gonna start turning back on. How are you feeling? 20 seconds to go. 20 seconds to go. Do another turn for me. Awesome. We got 15 seconds to go. And there's your countdown. We'll go 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, let me have you duck your head. All right, you could step out whenever you're ready. So you're gonna feel a little tingling sensation. Yeah. That's normal. Those are the endorphins kicking in.
Okay.
So now over the next 24 to 48 hours, your body will have that super enriched blood flowing through.
Do you feel so? Just finished up with my first cryo session with Sid over at Alpha Cryo, and it was awesome. He's very nice, very informative. So I'm gonna link his website underneath in the description, just so you guys can check him out.
Hello.
What, you want to go for a walk soon? All right, let me finish this. All right, so another thing that you want to pay attention to when you figure out your training, your recovery, your workouts and stuff like that is how you split your workouts. You want to make sure that you're not overtraining a specific muscle group or body part. You know, everyone's heard of the classic bodybuilding style training where you do chest and tries on one day, back and buys on another, legs on another. You want to do something that allows you time in between each body part. So for me, I personally like to do like a push-pull split. So I like to do all my push exercises on one day. So, you know, your squats, your bench press, your shoulder press, all that stuff on one day. All the muscles that are involved with the push would be like your quads, your chest, your triceps, your shoulders, your delts. So all that stuff in one day. And then on another day, what you would do is you would train all your pull exercises. So that would be like your deadlifts, your pull-ups, your rows. So that would involve your hamstrings, your glutes, lower back, upper back, traps, lats, biceps, all that stuff. And by splitting up that way, you can train, you know, your push and your pulls multiple times a week without overtraining. You know, you don't want to do chest on one day, shoulders on one day, triceps on one day, and then chest again, because that would just be way too taxing on those muscle groups and you're just not giving it enough time to rest. So make sure you're giving your muscles enough resting time. Just to give you an example, this is just a workout template that I have. So your push day, I don't know if you guys can see that, but flat bench press, standing shoulder press, you got your flies, and you got some dumbbell incline presses and lateral raises. So again, all that stuff is your chest and your shoulders. And then on another day, you got all your pull exercises. So over here, you got some deadlifts, some chin-ups, bent over rows, pull downs. So that would be all your pull exercises on another day. And then you can repeat that or, you know, whatever. All right, so another thing that you should do to aid in your recovery is active recovery. Most people like to take it real easy on their rest days. They don't really lift, they don't exercise, they kind of just chill. And every now and then that's actually good, but usually active recovery is better. So just moving around. So like I said earlier, usually when I have my rest days, I like to do mobility drills, some stretching, and I also like to do light cardio. So that could be anything from biking, you know, some incline walking on the treadmill, some slow Stairmaster, what else? Some light sports every now and then is cool. And today, walking my dog. Well, walking my dinosaur. So yeah, active recovery is good. It, you know, gets your body moving, especially after like a hard workout, your body gets really stiff. Muscles get tight, so moving it around will promote blood flow. It'll just promote just loosening everything up. It'll promote the recovery. And so, yeah, do active recovery. All right, so that pretty much wraps up the video. Hopefully you guys got some good information for recovery. Maybe in the future I'll put out a video with like more details on each and every one of the recovery procedures, practices that I do. But again, hopefully you guys got something from it. So now I'm just gonna pick up some Thai food because it's Thursday, because Thai Thursday, it's a thing, right? So I'm gonna pick that up, finish my macros, and then call it a night. So again, thank you for watching. Don't forget to click that thumbs up. Peace.